Welcome to the YouTube Barber Academy. Over the course of my 18-year career, I've tried every shortcut you can imagine. I've tried every workaround and every fade technique and everything you could possibly do, so I could really streamline this learning process for you, and I finally come up with something that's a really efficient way to get everything done that will give you great quality and great time as well. 10 of those years I spent in a barber school, trying to teach other people through trial and error. I would try to give them way too much at first, they would get overwhelmed, they wouldn't learn, it wouldn't stick. I kept trying, failing, succeeding, trying, failing, succeeding, and finally I came up with a way to departmentalize the learning and really help you guys to understand it. And I break the fade down into 6 simple phases. So that's what today's video is about. We're gonna go through what these phases are. This is not a tutorial. I just wanna show you guys a good order of operations for efficiency when you cut hair so you can perform a quality haircut in a short amount of time. Let's go. Just a quick note before I get into all this. I cover every one of these phases on my live show once a week. So if you guys haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit subscribe, hit that bell so that you know when them lives are coming. We teach for a whole hour and we go in depth on all of these things. Let's get started. It makes the most sense for me in my mind to get all the stuff that is both fast and easy done quickly. So the first thing we're gonna talk about is debulking. Generally performed by most barbers with a debulking clipper or a detachable clipper that can handle tremendous amounts of hair quickly, efficiently, with far less passes than say a magnetic motor or your average cordless. So what I prefer to do is knock the sides down if a client comes in with really long hair with maybe a 1.5 or a 2, set myself up for some clipper over comb, also put in the skin line and remove all that bulk and get rid of every bit of that hair below. And finally, for the last part of phase 1, we're actually gonna run the electric shaver underneath, removing all the hair down to complete skin, all the while being careful as we approach our skin line, not to go directly into it, but to leave us a tiny bit of separation so that we can perform our blend effortlessly in the next few steps. All right, phase 2. Phase 2 is a little complicated. It's clipper over comb. Actually, it's really simple after you practice it a while. So I would recommend that you either A, watch this video for clipper over comb, that can really help you, then circle back to this order of operations video. But B, just understand that performing the clipper over comb in this portion means that we have essentially already pre-cut the hair down to a 1.5 or a 2, and now we're just gonna connect that number 2 length into whatever length we're going to perform on top using clipper over comb to sort of perform like the rough draft. So once phase 2 is over, you've essentially connected the sides to the top. There's still gonna be some fine tuning and we'll actually handle that in phase 3. So in phase 3, we're gonna talk about how we cut the top, what technique we use to cut the top so that I can give you something that you can feel confident with whatever walks through the door. So we did the clipper over comb, that's kind of like the rough draft. There's still gonna be some loose ends that need to be tied up. And that's when we'll go back in with some shear over comb. And if you need practice at shear over comb, I also have this video here. You guys can head over to that and you guys can learn in an in-depth way how to perform the shear over comb or catch me on the lives. Phase 4, the blend. I like to savor this part for last. This is my favorite part. I like to watch it all come together in this step. All right, we've already done the entire top. We've connected that number 2 length into the top. We've done a shear over comb, clipper over comb, and we're looking really good. Couple things to remember about the blend. Hold your clipper flat. Understand the process. If you don't understand the process, I have over 200 videos. Many of them will help you understand the process. Recognize when it's time to put the clipper down and return to shear over comb or texturizing shears. Understand the guards. Know how they work together. Understand the fade scale and know what each guard length is so that you know what the neighboring guard length is and what you can pick up next, or if you have to return to a step, you know exactly where to go. Using the crisscross method where we travel back and forth to help the clipper pick up the most hair, holding it flat and staying anchored on the head. These are essentials for the blend. Now, on to phase 5. Phase 5 is the edge up, but just a handful of things to help you through your edge ups. I like to begin in the center and work my way out towards the edges on a client who walks in with a decent hairline. But if a client walks in and they have one side really low and one side really high, never start on the high side because all you're ever going to do is wind up pushing the high side even higher, which means you're gonna have to take even more hair off the low side. And a lot of times I like to anchor alongside of my client one way or another. So if I'm arching around the ears, I'm anchoring on the head. anchor on the head is gonna keep you steady so that you can get these edges perfect. And most importantly of all, when it comes to the edge up, you must use your mirror for perspective. I have videos that teach you how to do a full face shave, but in the edge up, you're gonna have to learn how to use the razor as well. So we'll learn the four strokes, when and where to apply them. So phase six, this is the last and final phase. And many barbers don't even do this. But imagine if you wrote an entire book and you didn't bother to check for any mistakes. When you handed it in to your publisher, the publisher would be like, what the heck is this? All right, so you're gonna have to pay a lot more to get that thing edited. Well, let's make sure that our edits are perfect. Let's make sure that our haircuts are perfect. So before we hand our client the mirror, let's give them a thorough once over. Let's look everywhere, look anywhere and everywhere. And if there is any cleanup to be done, go ahead and do the cleanup. If you're very thorough, your cleanup is gonna be minimal. And you're just gonna try to use the corners, texturize, and make sure that everything blends well. And the very last step to phase six is proudly handing your client the mirror. They look into it, they love what they see because you followed all six phases of the fade. If you're on the journey to become a barber, this is a total resource for you. I hope that you had the courage to just hit that button, hit subscribe, stick around, leave some comments, and let me help answer some of the questions. And definitely join us on the lives where you can really, really start to hammer some of this stuff home. Once again, this is the order of operations. This is how I feel things can be done most efficiently. And part of the reason why I made this video was also as a reminder to myself when I'm teaching exactly which phase I'm teaching, because I always felt like it was easiest to teach a student in a very departmentalized way rather than showing you everything at once because it's just too much to take. Once again, this is the YouTube Barber Academy. I am Mr. Eddie Barber, and I just wanna thank you from the bottom of my heart for helping me to reach 75,000 subscribers. I never could have done it without you guys, and stay tuned for my next videos. Peace.